guys like Flowers back in the day made it where we are right now in this park today. It wasn't for guys like him. We was doing parks like this back in the 70s, man. What the guys are doing now is old time. They think everything came out of the Manhattan, the Bronx, but it came right here in Brooklyn. Bro. So Flowers, Maboya, Plummer, the Smith Brothers, P.T. Jones, those are the pioneers for me, were the ones that started Mobile Jock. I got like 36 years playing music, and I guess back in the day when everybody was going to the club, there wasn't enough clubs for all the DJs. I made my money and made my experiences in my lifetime in the roller skate business. And I've been doing that for 24 years at Empire. Technically, I've been in the skate world like 31 years, but I've been a DJ for like 36 years. Man. So, you know, in my life right now, I got no ring, I got no club, but I've been blessed. Through all the stuff I've been through in my life, music been real good to me.
I'm happy to be filming something like this in Farragut because, you know, Farragut, we don't have no history. Nobody ever talks about our DJs. Nobody really talks about our history. And it's a shame because we got a strong history. A lot of the Brooklyn DJs don't get a lot of play. They don't get a lot of mention. But I'm happy to be an example of one of the DJs that, you know, I'm still representing for the people that's out here that want to hear something different. I don't play the normal stuff that people want to hear, like the commercial stuff, because I wasn't driven by that. I came up in a different era, and I had different experiences. And even though I went to college through the crack era, I went to school through the crack era, I didn't become a part of that part of the society that you know, or part of the product that was in the society. So, you know, I was reaching out, I was going deeper than that. And so my legacy, as far as a man is concerned, I think, you know, my family's proud of me. I know my mother's proud of me, you know, because of what I was able to achieve here. When I first was learning how to play classic house music and really learning how to play house music for black people that wanted that Paradise Garage experience, I had to go to Debonair to get those records. Even though I heard them from DJ Camacho from Space, I had to go get them from DJ Debonair, who was able to provide the sound for my college parties. He was the person that wrote my name and given me a great sound for my college parties when I was doing house music parties in college. So I was able to keep that and continue that legacy on, and it's been a great help to me. Now you have other DJs that's out here, but the legacy and the foundation always started with Flowers and then Straight. My mother used to go see Straight. Obviously everybody knows Straight, who set it off.
He was a DJ and Straight could mix very, very, very well. I mean, this guy could put two records together and mix, and he had a terrific small but compact sound system. You know, he's a guy that made such an international record. It went global. That record hit everywhere, and it was like number one at the time. I don't recall what particular year that was, but everybody played Set It Off. All of the DJs out the urban areas and Farragut and whatnot, and when they heard he was from Farragut houses, you know, they kind of embraced him that much more because they know he came through the trenches or the trials and tribulations that all of these other people had went through, you know, so they know, you know, he was a spoon-fed that, you know, it came from hard work, all of his accomplishments and stuff like that. But to survive this, a lot of times you just got to give a person credit for it, without being on any kind of drugs and substances, alcoholism and all of these kind of things that these projects can grab you, you know, and consume you by, you know. I could say we done stole that kind of stuff.
They all come from here, and all of this musicality that we've had has been a great tradition. Charlie Victor, who lives down there, he's one of the founding DJs that I used to go over the bridge, and at any given Saturday, I would go hear him spin and play music. He would play music, and everybody would come out from around the way. The same thing I can say about Shadi. these are the DJs that I used to come up listening to, and eventually I said, you know what? I think I want to be a DJ too.
You had to take equipment after a party and put it into the band, and we just, from there they upgraded it to be easier, but we had to really be strong in this project. And this project, and all the projects we went over to 4-3. We played over in places, we had to really step our game up.
Kenny Carpenter actually played for Mike Stone over at Studio 54, and then he played at a couple of other locations, and now he's actually in Europe playing. And Kenny Carpenter came from the same location, same building. He was on the first floor. He came from a family of like 9 brothers, you know, so, you know, and he came and he survived all of this as well. You know, he survived the drugs and the gangs and this and that, you know. And he was just involved in his music. He just loved his music. One of the bass players for Shannon was a really, really good friend of hers. And his name was Russell Taylor. Rusty Taylor used to be the bass player for Shannon. So there we have another musician. Like Disciples brother played with George Benson. He was the bass player at one time for George Benson. So Rusty played for Shannon, the bass player, and also a little bit for John Luciani. And different establishments start wanting permits, and they started getting technical. And then unfortunately, we started to go through the crack era, and we started to, you know, get drug infested and stuff like that. So that changed a whole lot of things, you know, as far as being able to just come out and play music on a whim, I guess you would say, because we didn't have no schedule, we didn't have no flyers. It used to be word of mouth that DJ Shadi was playing around his way, and people would gather around and listen to some good music. The music was free. It was free. It was absolutely free. We still have the passion for the music. We still have the passion for playing and blending and representing that music to the fullest, you know? And the thing is I can say I've been blessed, because I took it on as a company, but there's times where I give total give backs, you know? And that's very important, that you take from the community, you give back to the community. You know, you have a hand for receiving and a hand for giving.
Cops don't want you out there because they scared. They trying to control the crowd. They don't want you out there a certain time. They don't want you doing what you need to really be doing to have a good time. So they not giving out the permits. When the music is on, they shut you down. They making you cut it off. You know what I mean? They asking for permits, but they won't even give you the permit. So even when they used to, my man China used to come out with his set, you know what I mean? And it's just not the same no more.